टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर एंड डिस्कशन ऑन द डॉक्टर रोबर्ट कैप्लन एंड डेविड नॉर्टन से बैलेंस स्कोर कार्ड इज यूज्ड फॉर द परफॉर्मेंस मेजरमेंट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल परफॉर्मेंस मेजरमेंट ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल परफॉर्मेंस इट इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट tool for the performance measurement. The balance scorecard creates a template of measurement of the organizational performance as well as individual performance. It is a measurement-based management system which enables organizations to clarify the vision and strategy before initiating action. It is also a monitoring system that integrates the strategy into the performance measures and the targets, thus making it operational and highly effective. It helps cascading corporate level measures to lower level so that the employee can see what they must do will to improve the organizational effectiveness and helps to focus the entire organization. This is a very important that the employee can see what they must do will to improve the organizational effectiveness or for to improve the organization's effectiveness, what can be done, and helps focus the entire organization on what must be done to create breakthrough performance. To create the breakthrough performance, what the employee has to be done? This can be given by the balance scorecard. Balance scorecard was introduced in the 1992 by the Dr. Robert Kaplan and the David Norton, and has been successfully adopted by the numerous company worldwide. Many of the company of the world has adopted the balance scorecard for improving the breakthrough of the performance of the organization. The balance scorecard method is a strategic approach and the performance management system that enables the organization to translate its vision and strategy into the implementation. The balance scorecard is a conceptual framework for translating an organization's vision into a set of the performance indicator distributed among the four perspectives. The four perspectives are the financial, customer, internal business processes, learning, and the growth. Indicators are maintained to measure and organize and progress toward achieving its vision. Other indicators are maintained to measure the long-term drivers of the success. Through this scorecard, an organization monitors both its current performance, finances, customer satisfaction, and business process results, and its efforts to improve processes, motivate and educate employee, and enhance information system, its ability to learn and improve. Through this, the scorecard and organization monitor both its the current performance, finances, customer satisfaction, and business process result, and its effort to improve the processes, motivate and educate the employee, and enhance the information system. It is the ability to learn and improve. A balanced scorecard enables us to measure not just how we have been doing, but also how well we are doing. This is the hence, this is the beauty of the balanced scorecard, which enables us to measure just how we have been doing, but how well we are doing. Current indicators and can expect to do in the future. Leading indicator. This in turn gives a clear picture of the reality. Hence, the balance scorecard is a way of the measuring organizational, business units, or the departmental success. Number two, balancing long-term and the short-term actions. Number three, balancing different measures of the success. Financial, customer, and internal operation, human resource system, and the development, learning, and the growth. It measures the success of the financial success, which is very important for the organization. Customer success, which is very important for the organization. Internal operations, human resource systems, and development and learning and the growth. These are the way of the balance scorecard. Four kinds of the measures of the balance scorecard is there. The scorecard seeks to measure a business from the following perspective. Financial perspective. Measures reflective financial performance, for example, number of the debtors, cash flow, or return on investment. This is the very important for any of the organization. This is the financial perspective. The financial performance of an organization is the fundamental to its success. For non-profit organization must take the books balance. Financial figures suffer from the two major drawbacks. Customer perspective. This perspective captures the ability of the organization to provide quality goods and the services. The ability of the organization to provide the quality goods and the services. Effective delivery and overall customer satisfaction for both the internal and the external customers. Customer satisfaction is the best measure. Example time taken to process a phone call, results of the customer service, number of the complaints, or the competitive ranking. Results of the customer service, number of the complaints, or the competitive ranking. This is the customer perspective. Business process perspective. This perspective provides data regarding the internal business results against the measure that lead to the financial success and satisfied customers. To meet the organizational objective and customers' expectation, organizations must identify the key business processes. What are the key business processes are there to meet the organizational objectives and the customer expectation? Customer expectations are the important at which they must excel. Key processes are monitored to ensure that outcomes are satisfactory. Internal business processes are the mechanism through which performance expectations are achieved. Example, the time spent prospecting the new customers, number of units that required rework, or the process cost. This is the business process perspective. The time spent prospecting the new customers, number of new units that required rework, or the process cost. This is the business process perspective. Learning and the growth perspective. This perspective captures the ability of the employee, notes information, system, and organizational alignment to manage the business and adapt to change. Process will only succeed if adequately skilled and motivated employee supplied with the accurate and the timely information are driving them. in order to meet changing requirement and the customer expectation, employees are being asked to take on the dramatically new responsibility that may require skills, capability, technology, and the organizational designs that were not available before. These are the learning and the growth. Process will only be succeed if adequately skilled and motivated employee supplied with the accurate and the timely information are driving them in order to meet the changing requirement and the customer expectation. Employee are being asked to take on the dramatically new responsibility. New responsibility that may require skills, capability, technology, and the organizational design that were not available before. It measures the company's learning curve, for example, number of the employee session or total hours of the spent on the staff training. Objective measures targets and the initiative. What are the objectives? What are the measures? What are the targets? And what are the initiatives are there? Within each of the balance scorecard, financial customer, internal process, and the learning perspective, the organization must define the following. Number one, strategic objective. The strategy for achieving that perspective. Measures how progress for that particular objective will be measured. Targets, the target value sought for the each measure. Initiative, what will be done to facilitate reaching out the target. The balance scorecard provides an interconnected model for the measuring the performance and revolves around four distinct perspectives: financial, customer, internal process, and the innovation and the learning. Financial perspective is the most important thing. Customer orientation, customer satisfaction is the most important thing, and the internal process improvement of the internal process must be important. And innovation and the learning is the most important thing for the any of the organization. Each of these perspectives is stated in terms of the organization's objectives, performance measures, targets, and initiative, and all are harnessed to implement corporate vision and strategy. The name also reflects the balance between the short and long-term objectives, between the financial and non-financial measures, between the lagging and leading indicators, and between the external and internal performance perspective. Under the balance scorecard system, financial measures are the outcome but don't give a good indication of what is or will be going on the organization's. Measure of the customer satisfaction, growth and retention in the current indicator of the company performance, and internal operations, efficiency, speed, reducing non-value added work, minimizing the quality problems are the important for the customer satisfaction. And the human resource system and development are the leading indicators of the company performance. Robertus Kaplan and David P. Norton, the architect of the balanced scorecard approach, recognized early that the long-term improvement in the overall performance was unlikely to happen through the technology only, and hence placed greater emphasis on the organizational learning and the growth. These in turn consist of the integrated development of the employee information and the system capability. How to enhance performance through the balance scorecard. In such constantly shifting environment, management must learn to continuously adapt to the new strategy that can emerge from the capitalizing on the opportunity or the countering threats. A properly constructed balance scorecard can provide management with the ideal tool in reaching to the turbulent environment and helping the organization to correct the course of the success. A scorecard provides the manager with feedback, thus enabling them to monitor and adjust the implementation of their strategy, even to the extent of the changing the strategy itself. In today's information age, organizations operate in very turbulent environment. planned strategy, thou initiated with the best of the intention and with the best available information at the time of the planning, may longer be appropriate or valid for the contemporary conditions. As company have applied the balance scorecard, they have to begin to recognize that the scorecard represents a fundamental change in underlying the assumption about the performance measurement. The scorecard puts strategy and vision, not control, at the center. It establishes goals, but assumes that people will adopt whatever behaviors and take whatever actions are necessary to arrive at these goals. The measures are designed to pull people toward the overall vision. Senior manager may know what the end result should be, but they cannot imply exactly how to achieve that result, because the condition in which the employee operate are constantly changing. This new approach to performance measurement is consistent with the initiative underway in the many organizations. Cross-functional integration, customer-supplier partnership, global scale, continuous improvement, and the team rather than individual accountability. By combining the financial, customer, internal process, and innovation, and organization learning perspective, the balanced scorecard helps managers understand, at least implicitly, many interrelationships. This understanding can help managers transcend traditional notions about the functional barriers and ultimately lead to the improved decision making, problem solving, and enhanced performance. The balanced scorecard keeps organizations moving forward. Hence, this is the utility of the balanced scorecard. Hence, today we have discussed about the balanced scorecard, how to enhance the performance through the balanced scorecard, objective measure targets and initiative of the balanced scorecard, learning and the growth perspective, business process perspective, customer perspective, financial perspective, four kinds of the measures of the balance scorecard. We have discussed about the balance scorecard.